Hello everyone, welcome to Art From Heart. In today's video, I will be showing you the transformation of our dining room. But before we start with the transformation, here's a quick look at some before pictures. The dining room has an archway that takes us into the living room, which makes the dining room look bigger and more open. The wallpaper on the walls and the ceiling was wrapped around the archway from the front room to the dining room. The wallpaper was so old that it started decaying on the walls and started losing its design. On the ceiling was a broken chandelier that was hanging sideways, but it was still functioning. It was outdated and missing some pieces. The floor was covered with a green carpet that was laid out all the way to the living room. Since the house had no central air, a small window air unit was installed in one of the dining room windows. The radiator was located underneath the window to keep the cold out that was coming in through the window. We started by removing all the wallpaper of the walls first. My father-in-law is an electrician and he set up recessed lighting in each corner of the room and installed all new receptacles because the electrical was outdated and not up to code. Now, the thermostat control didn't work either and it had to be replaced with a new one. We pulled 14-2 Romex indoor wire to replace all the fabric-covered NMC electrical wire. In order for us to do that, we had to cut out small pocket holes in the walls and pull the wires from the basement to the ceiling to get them to the lights and the chandelier. After everything was done, the insulated rated recess housings was installed and most of the ceiling wallpaper was removed. Once all electrical was done, we removed the old chandelier and we set up a temporary light. We began painting the room with the bare product paint that we use on all of our rooms in the house. The ceiling was painted with white color and the walls were painted with the skylight blue color. It was time to lift the carpet and see what laid underneath of it. Surprisingly, the floor was in a better condition than I expected, but it had some dark and light spots around the room and had a few scratches here and there, but no major damage. The radiator was the last piece that was in the way for the room to be fully painted. Since my wife and I were planning on getting a new central air and heating system in the house, we drained the water from the radiators and I cut the radiator pipes to dismount it. Once I moved out the radiator, we realized that the wallpaper behind it was burnt. We removed it, but the wall crack was another thing that needed to be fixed. Once the floor was done, we painted the walls and the room was ready to have the floor sanded down and restained. I used an orbital sander to sand down the floors. I purchased the medallion on the Amazon. I used acrylic paint to paint the medallion with many colors. When it was finished, I installed it, the medallion, and then I put a new chandelier. After all the electrical was completely done and room was completely lit, the floors were ready to be stained. Once the floors were stained, we waited 24 hours for it to cure. Now be sure to check the instructions on the stain for the dry time, because sometimes it takes more than 24 hours for it to cure and depends on the brand that you go with, it might be different. So don't take my word for it, check your instructions when you use it. Using semi-gloss polyurethane as a coat for the floors was a process that needed to be repeated 3 times and included a few steps. First, we applied the polyurethane and then let it cure for 24 hours. Then, we buffered the floors with a floor buffer. After that, we applied a second coat of polyurethane and waited for it to cure for another 24 hours. After those 24 hours, I had to buff the floors one more time and recoat it with last coat of polyurethane. Now, once you're done with that, you do not want to buff it the third time because you will scratch the floor. Once you use your third coat of polyurethane, you should be done and the floors should be complete. Just wait 24 more hours for it to cure, and I believe it takes about 7 days, about a week or two before you can start putting any furniture on it, and I think it's about a month that you have to wait before you can lay down any rugs if you want to. Last but not least, the new central air was installed. The trim was finally painted, and I got a chance to install a new window rod that would match our new blue walls. I would say thank you to all of you who has been watching my channel, and I welcome all new subscribers. Thank you very much. If you haven't had a chance, don't forget to subscribe for more videos just like this one. I hope I have inspired some of you to be more artistic and motivated, and remember that your creativity has no limit. Thank you all, until next time.